If you've got a bunch of records in your Airtable, it's helpful to have a way to make the most important ones stand out. For example, let's say that I'm using Airtable to manage all the aspects of an upcoming product launch. I may want to flag projects that are overdue, so that I immediately know which tasks are most urgent. I might also want to highlight records that are due in the next week, so that I make sure that they are high on my priority list. Let's dive into a few tactics you can use to flag your most important records. One great way to flag certain records is with a ProPlan feature called Record Coloring. This allows you to color code certain records based on a single select field, custom filtering conditions, or a date field. Record coloring is applied at the view level, so each of your views can have its own unique color coding configuration. In this table, you can see that I have a single select field called Value, which denotes if a task is of high or low value to the project. I may want to know an individual task's value at a glance, because it will help me decide what to prioritize. This is where record coloring comes in. Let's navigate to the view bar at the top of the screen and click on Color. This produces a drop-down menu with different color coding options. Let's choose Select Field. Now, all of my single select fields appear in the drop-down list. If I choose Value, then each record is marked with the color of its accompanying value status. High-value records are now marked with a yellow bar, and low-value records with a green bar. This can be a helpful way to quickly and easily discern a crucial detail about a record without doing any digging. You can also use record coloring to mark records that match a certain set of conditions. For example, let's say I'd like records that have due dates within the next week to be flagged so that I can keep them top of mind. Record coloring can highlight these records so that you can quickly discern that they have an upcoming due date. To get started, let's create a new record coloring configuration by again clicking on the paint bucket icon in the view bar. This time, let's choose conditions. I'll choose a color, say bright pink, and then set the parameters so that all records that have a target completion date within the next week and have not been completed yet will be color-coded. Now, a bright pink mark has been added to all of these specific records. The great thing about this feature is that at any point in time, any incomplete project that's set to be launched within the next week will automatically be marked as pink, with no further legwork on your part. Record coloring can also be used across all the views and look a little different in each one. In the calendar view, you have the additional option to color code according to date fields. If you have more than one date field for a record, say a completion date and a launch date, you can assign each one a different color to differentiate between them on your calendar. Another helpful way to mark important records is with the conditional formula field. Let's say that I want records that are incomplete and past their target due date to be explicitly marked as overdue. I can do this by creating a new formula field, and I'll call it status. Then I can translate this need to the following formula. If the completed checkbox is unchecked, say nothing. If the target due date has already passed, say overdue. And if a record doesn't meet either of those conditions, then again, say nothing. I'll hit save, and now you can see that the records that are not completed and passed their target completion date are immediately listed as overdue. This field will automatically update as changes are made to your records, so it always stays accurate and up to date. Record coloring and conditional formulas are super robust features, and you can use them to customize your views any way you like. So now that you have a quick overview of how they work, go ahead and give them a try on your own. If you have any questions, don't hesitate to refer to our support articles or community forum. And remember, you can always drop us a line if you need a little more guidance. Thanks for watching, and see you next time.